you are good. You will never become great. If you want to become great, go beyond goodness. Be happy. You should be happy all the time. At home, in the hostel, with friends, with teachers, with guests, you should be happy. Make us also happy. You see, when you were born, or I was born and we were born, there are only two types of people here. One is learner, one is a teacher. One is a student, one is a teacher. In each one of us, we have both teachers and students. We are all made up of teachers and students. Remember this. When we were born with a very special organ called brain. The brain came along with other organs. After some time, there was a quality of the brain which started we recognizing that, called mind. Mind. Again, there are two types of minds. Today you have decided to which type of mind you must belong to on the day of entering this great institution. After I heard Professor Ashwath, you know, I was envying you. Why did you not admit me to this college? I could have been sitting there, I could have become one personality like you here. The mind with which you have entered here is a different mind of students who have entered the medical institution, KIMS. Two types of minds. These minds, unlike my mind, unlike my colleague Dr. Raghunath's mind, your mind is a creative mind. Engineer's mind is always creative. You want to create. Whereas your other brothers and sisters in the next institution, their mind is a curative mind. They want to cure. Therefore, you have decided without knowing or knowingly, unknowingly, you wanted to be creative mind. What is that creativity? If you want to know what is creativity, as an engineer, you are already an engineer. The day you decided to study this wonderful subject, engineering and technology, you have inbuilt, recognized creativity in you. Creativity is combination of three things. Like in mathematics, A is equal to B plus C plus D, you know. Creativity is a combination of competence, number one. Competence, I'll tell you about competence little later, plus righteousness in the heart, truthfulness. You should be truthful all the time. Righteousness in the heart, plus one important thing, you must have courage to speak out the truth. Competence, what is competence? Your qualification, your training, experience will make you competent. Once you are competent, you will become creative with additional important things like courage or truthfulness and courage to speak out truth. I'll give you one simple example of an engineer. He never studied BE, he never studied AMI, he never studied, went to any college, but he was an engineer. This engineer was in Orissa. Between Bhuvaneshwar and Konark, I was traveling by car. Halfway through, I saw a place where there were a lot of beautifully carved idols on stone carving. I asked my driver to stop the car. I was traveling along with Dr. Abdul Kalam. Both of us were in the same car. We got down. We went to that shop. He had number of idols, Ganesha idols, beautifully carved. All were looking alike, identical. Then Dr. Kalam asked me, Professor, you want to buy this? I said, I would like to buy. You already have at home, you know, I have seen. I said, I want to give it as a gift. To whom you want to give it as a gift? I will tell you later, I said. When I saw that, all were identical, like these water bottles on this table. All identical. We don't know which is original, which is duplicate. I asked him, ye kitne ka hai? He said, 800 rupees, sir. Then I picked up one. Ye de do. He said, ye bechne ka nahi, sir. This is not for sale. I said, why do you keep it here if it is not for sale? I want this. He said, sorry, sir. I said, I looked all around. I could not find any defect. Then I said, ye theek hai. I'll give you, 600 rupees. Because 800, he said, he will not sell, you know. Okay, I said, I'll give you 1,000 rupees. He said, no, sir. I went up to 2,000 rupees, 3,000 rupees. He refused to give this. I said, are you mad? All other things you can give it to me for 800. I will give you 3,000 rupees. Why don't you give me? Then he said, sir, I only created this. I know there's a defect in this. How can I sell you the defective idol, sir? I said, I can't make out, doesn't matter. I'll give you 600 rupees, give me that. I brought down the price because he said defect. We always do, you know, seconds. When you go buy seconds, you demand at lower price. Then he said, sir, I know there is a defect. How can I sell it to you? You may not know. He had skill to create. He had the truthfulness to speak out. He had the courage to speak out the truth. My dear young friends, remember in your life, you must be truthful. You should have courage to speak out the truth without fear. Coming to the engineers, creative minds. You must have read Dr. Abdul Kalam's book, Creative Minds, Creativity. That's what I wish I was sitting next to you. Creativity is the mother of all inventions, mother of all innovations, mother of all discoveries. Three words I have used: discovery, invention, innovation. All the three. Who has done this? If you look at Benjamin Frank, you know he discovered electricity. He discovered electricity. Forgot. Who invented, using that electricity, many gadgets, electric bulbs, electric heater? Who? Then somebody discovered which was already there. Nobody can discover something which is not there. Something is already there. Nobody has seen, nobody has noticed. It is there in front of us. A miracle is there in front of us. When a small ant, how beautiful it moves around, how it carries 10 times its weight, how it organizes its shelter, how it has a discipline, discover. It is there in front of us. You discover. What you discover, somebody more intelligent, an engineer like you, will come out with invention. Engineers are the first inventors of many gadgets we are using, whether my earlier speakers mentioned, whether this or the projection. Engineers have invented. They did not keep quiet. After inventing, they started improving. Continual improvement. That is called innovation. You know, when the first cell phone came in 1983, I remember, per minute it was 8 rupees. Per minute. The cell phone was this big, like handy tools, you know. It was so big. Today, I am told the cell phones are so small, can be implanted under your skin. You will have a hearing, but it can be implanted. What you think, what you talk is communicated to that particular person. Future of technology. That means things are getting improved by day by day. Who is doing it? Engineers. That is you people. What is that medical people are doing? You don't know. Without your knowledge, they are using every skill, every talent in every one of you. I am the standing example, I tell you. In a medical institution, will come to stand still if there are no engineers, if there are no technologists. You are the people who are running the healthcare system. You are the people who are the custodians of healthcare system. Doctors are custodians of sickness care centers. They care for the sick. We unfortunately, without understanding, we say healthcare organization. Healthcare is by municipality, where public engineers, they make the drain, they make the clean environment. When the engineers fail, mosquitoes will breed, disease will spread, doctors will come to cure the patients. They are curative. You are creative, they are curative. Next time when you meet your friend who has joined medicine, tell them, I am a creative man, I am a Vishwakarma, engineers are Vishwakarmas. We are a curative man. Dhanvantaris, curative. They were only interested in curing patients, curing diseases, treating diseases. You go to any hospital, why? You go to Kim's hospital, take a walk. Show me one healthy person lying on any bed. They're all sick people, isn't it? Some have one disease, some have two diseases, some have many diseases. What these doctors, nurses and paramedicals do? They take care of sickness. What is that organization? Sickness Caring Organization. We should be very proud to say, I belong to Sickness Caring Organization, whereas you belong to health care, caring for the health of people by creating an appropriate environment, whether through your skills, innovations, inventions. Friends, you have joined today. 4 years will just go like that. You ask them, they will tell you. They don't know how they spent 4 years. Most of the time in the canteen. That time this was a theater. You must have seen a lot of movies in this theater. I still remember. One thing I'm missing, that red colored exit board on this side, that side, it's not there. It was a theater. Enjoyed. You get every minute to enjoy. Don't miss that. What you should not miss, you must gain that knowledge, skill, even to enjoy. You are the people who can solve problems. Doctors will only handle problems. To help them to solve problems, you are responsible, you are required. I'll tell you how. In every hospital, there's a department called biomedical engineering. About 5 years ago, the biomedical engineers also wanted to put that prefix doctor in behind their name. Doctor so-and-so. The Biomedical Engineering Society of United States of America, I was there in that committee, they said, we will change this biomedical engineering, BME, to clinical engineering. Why I'm telling you, our VITU, our registrar is sitting here, I am going to make an appeal to you, please communicate to them. All the biomedical engineers who graduate must be called clinical engineers. Because they are the people who can devise a tool to measure the blood pressure, it's a physical parameter, to measure the corneal pressure, to detect glaucoma. They can measure electrical impulses with galvanic skill response. They are electrical people. Therefore, they are called clinical engineers. These clinical engineers, they know more physiology, they know better anatomy than physiologists and anatomists. Some of you may decide to become clinical engineers. We have genetic engineering. If you look at the genetic engineering, I'll not go into the details. What do they do? They do trimming and joining. What is not required in the gene, they cut and remove. What is required, they put it and paste it. Genetic engineering, again engineering, again skill, again innovation, again to take care of the health. Artificial intelligence, four types. Who has created this? Again, engineers. Why I'm telling you, my day never starts without an engineering tool. My day never ends without an engineering tool. Example, the toothbrush I use, tissue paper I use. Who created this? It's an engineer. He knew what should be the softness of your tissue paper. He knew what should be the shape and size and tensile strength of the toothbrush. Engineering. What a wonderful thing. Engineers learned these things by observation, by listening to others. There are two things I am using here, two words. Listening. I hope you are all listening to me. Are you listening to me? Okay. Are you observing me? With more curiosity that this fellow looks like Abdul Kalam, you are observing me. I know. Amongst these two, listening and observation, which is an essential foundation for every engineer, what is more important? Is listening more important than observation, or observation more important than listening? Now, all those who think listening is more important than observation, raise your hands. Nobody is listening to me. No hands are going up. Okay, how many of you think observation is more important than listening? About 25%. How many of you think both are equally important? Some of them are raising both their hands. But I believe listening is not important. It is stupid. Observation is idiotic. Do you agree with me? Listening is stupid. Don't listen to us. Listen to yourself. Observation is idiotic. Do you agree with me? Nobody will agree with me. Now, I would like to play 1 minute game with all of you. Are you ready to play one game? Very good. They're getting bored sitting at the same place, you know. Okay. Please observe me carefully. Listen to me carefully. Don't make any noise. I am going to ask you to do something. You don't have to get up, jump at the same place, sit and do that. I'll tell you what to do. I will also demonstrate what I ask you to do so that I'll be your guide, okay? Like a teacher. All of you, please stretch your hand, right hand. You can also participate. Stretch your right hand. Don't poke somebody's face. Okay. Point your index finger like this. Listen to me carefully. Do what I ask you to do, madam. What I ask you to do. Look at me, I will demonstrate. Your index finger, I will ask you to do something, do that. Look at me, I will demonstrate. Put it on your chin. Put it on your chin. This is cheek. This is cheek. Chin is here. Listening is idiotic. Observation is stupid. Then what is more important? What is more important? Logic. Use the logic. This fellow standing on the dais on the, near the platform is asking us to put the finger on the chin, but he is putting it on the cheek. That thought should come. Unless you think, unless you apply logic, you will fail. Like what happened to us today. In life, carefully listen, observe, and then decide. You decide. Don't allow somebody else to decide what you should do. You have teachers. All are not same. What is same is you. Listen carefully. Observe meticulously. Decide logically. You will succeed. If you want to succeed in life, one day if you want to sit here on this platform, address new batch of students, follow that. Therefore, engineers, inventors, innovators who help the society thousands of times better than any other professional. If a lawyer makes a mistake during his argument, lawyers always argue, they don't discuss. When lawyers argue with an intent of who is right, whether he is right or I am right, when they discuss, when you discuss as an engineer, as a team, you heard about teamwork, you know. As an engineer, when you discuss as a team, you will decide what is right, not who is right. What is right is more important than who is right. You must develop that habit of discussion. When you do that, you will find only right things. There's nothing called wrong. There might be some problem. The problems you will come across in your life, during your studies, after your studies, there is nobody here who had no problem. All of them had problem. But every problem has a solution. If there is a problem without a solution, it is not called a problem. Every problem has a solution on this earth. If there is a problem, if you think for which there is no solution, it is not a problem. It is your problem. There are three types of personalities here. One, very good in solving problem. If there is a short circuit, go, switch off the main, prevent fire. They voluntarily go and solve the problem. They are very good in solving problem. The second type of personality, they are also very good in solving problem, but they wait for somebody to come and invite. They know there is a fire. They know, they watch, there is a fire. But somebody should come and, sir, will you please, madam, will you come, let us go and put off the fire. Then they say, oh, I know, you want my help? Come, I'll help you. They are also very good in solving problem. Third type of personality, very good in solving problem. This is a very important personality. They are very good in solving problem. If there is no problem, they create problem. And then they go and solve the problem. I had one teacher, physics teacher. We had an experiment in magnetism. The field, we had to determine the field. He used to come and stand next to us. It was all going heavy. He said, there must be some problem. Yes, sir, there's some problem. Whenever you come, this is going like this. You are the problem. No, wait, let me see. He used to put his hand in his pocket and take out a magnet. He used to carry to create problem and solve the problem. All of us, especially people of creativity, like engineers, they come across more problems than anybody else. But these are the engineers who come with the solution also. Friends, one incident I would like to quote here. I was with Dr. Abdul Kalam when we went to Chennai IIT Engineering Institute. That was the day when they invited us on the World Blindness Day. We did not go to blind school, we went to that IIT Chennai in Guindy. We had to give a talk. Like what I did, you know, today, let all my guests speak so that I can learn from them and I can make my talk. I'm very selfish, I tell you. Though you asked me to come here and speak, I wanted to educate myself, especially when you projected about this institution and the linkages and your achievements and opportunities. I started envying you, envying everybody. Why I did not get a seat to sit there? Maybe I am not fit to get into this institution. Maybe I am too old to learn. Then students were there. They said, "Sir, tell us what we can do during our student career. 5 years of studies, what can we do?" He said, "You can do whatever you want. Why do you want to ask me? You tell me what you want to do." One student came and said, "I want to create some tool wherein the blind can throw their stick." Blind people walk with that stick, you know, red and white painted stick. One student said, "Sir, we want to throw that stick, make that blind walk." He said, "How can you do that?" He said, "Sir, I'll create a shoes with a sensor at the front. That sensor will be connected through Wi-Fi to earbud. When they are walking, that sensor will detect, communicate what is there ahead of them. Where there's a hump, there's a dip, there's an obstacle, there's a moving object." This, Dr. Kalam asked, "How much time you need?" That boy said, "Sir, we are 5 of us, we want to take this project. Give us 1 week time." Look at that confidence. 1 week time. You know what Dr. Abdul Kalam said? "I'm going to stay in Chennai for 1 week. I will come back after 1 week. I want to see that what you have created, you are going to create." We stayed in the Anna University guest house. Every morning we used to enjoy the Murugan idli. We waited for 5 days. He was the advisor to Rakshaman, the scientific advisor to Rakshamantri that time. After 5 days, we went to that department. Students had created a shoes with a sensor in the front, which they had brought some blind students. They made them wear, made them walk around where a lot of obstacles were there. They proved that they were capable of doing it. Hats off to these engineers, I tell you. Fantastic. Each one of you can take up a short time explorative project. Talent. Create something. During your student days, you should be able to patent. I am looking at beyond what your teachers can do. Get one patent in your student days. You can achieve that. You have not come here just to study. You have not come here just to acquire knowledge. You have come here to create something. Make your institution great. BIT must be a great institution because of you. An institution is like a chair on which my guests are sitting with 4 legs. Every chair has 4 legs. If principal had given chair with 3 legs, imagine how difficult it would have been for us to sit. If you had created a chair with 2 legs, we wouldn't have refused to sit on that. There are chairs with 1 leg also. I'll tell you these 4 legs of the chair. This chair is this institution, BIT. You are sitting, you are in this institution, which is like a chair with 4 legs. 1 leg is called leg of learning and teaching. It's an institution where you learn, you teach. Only with best teachers, best learners, institution cannot sustain. There is a second leg. The second leg of this institution is a leg of service. You saw corporate social responsibility, what you projected. Service to the society. Whatever you do must be beneficial to somebody who does not know that subject. That is the service. Definition of service is somebody is benefited. Second leg. With two legs, institution is not sustainable. There's a third leg. Very important. Research and development. Every institution, every department, every teacher must have that research and development bent of mind. Even then that institution is not stable. The fourth leg. Do you know what is that fourth leg which makes this institution stable? Anybody? The fourth leg, whether for teachers or students, it is the leg of commitment and passion. I heard from one of my earlier speakers, if you have commitment and passion, wherever you are, in whichever position you are, that institution becomes the most stable institution, whether it is the engineering college, whether your home, whether your country. If you want that to be sustainable, you must have that commitment and passion along with the other three. Develop that. It doesn't cost money. You don't have to pay any donation for that. Friends, you have resources. You are a very lucky, extremely lucky. You have wonderful resources. 8 resources you have. You have human resources. When I was feeling very uncomfortable to sit when all the professors, faculty were standing behind us, I tell you. I also wanted to get up and stand, but they said, you are a retired professor, sit down. That's why I had to sit. Personal, one resource. Management, look at the management. Started with 2 great personalities. Ramegowda and our Kuvempu. Who can replace them, tell me? What a great personality, you know? Another resource, the management is an excellent resource. The third resource, methodology adopted in this institution. Look at how many companies are in the queue to take you away. They are all waiting to grab you. They are not training you. All the training given by the teachers, all the expenses covered by your parents, who is benefited? The companies. Next resource is the method, apart from methodology, the mechanism. And environment, fantastic environment, you have clean environment. Even if you are, sometime if you are sick, next door is a caring organization. That also is created by the Vakkaliga Sangha. Hats off to you, I tell you. I love the philosophy of creating 19 educational institutions, I counted all of them. 19, isn't it? Educational institutions. You are having the benefit of not only sustainable developmental goals of Mahatma Gandhi, which United Nations adopted. All these sustainable development goals were the goals which was declared and written down by Mahatma Gandhi, which United Nations adopted. You are lucky. You have 17 institutions, 19 institutions. There is the environment you have, fantastic environment. And more than anything, you have information management. He showed library, digital library, 24 hours library. You have information management at this center. Don't miss this. Use to the maximum extent. This information technology is now changing its shape, costume. It has become nano information technology. Nano information technology. If some of you can take up a project, I will support. I am a CEO of Foundation for Quality India. I would like to partner with this institution. My colleague has come, technical director is here. I will request our technical director to sign an MOU with you for nano information technology related projects. I'm an advisor to Government of India. I'll mobilize some resources for you in the first year itself. You should get at least one patent in your name when you are in this institution. It is possible. What is possible, you can do, I don't need your help, you don't need my help. What is impossible, let us make it possible together. We will join hands, make that impossible possible. I am extremely happy to be here today. What made me come here, I tell you, my morning walk. I go for a morning walk. You might be wondering, what is that morning walk has to do with me coming here? After my morning walk, some of us go. My friends have a cup of coffee or tea, where I met the former registrar of... Will you please stand, please? He did not know me. I did not know him. We only looked at each other. Probably we have the same wavelength of mind. We greeted. That's where it stopped. We did not even talk much. Then, I don't know what made him to come and ask me. He must have thought I'm a great scientist because of my hair. I am an ordinary student like you. Then he said, sir, will you come for to deliver a talk? I thought he has invited me to deliver a talk on my topic of interest, lead, plumbum, lead. Number one, environmental poison, which has its ill effect all over the world in everybody. Then he said something else. I said, okay. He only said, on what topic you will talk? I said, discovery, invention, innovation. That is the heart of engineers. Thank you very much for inviting me. Not only that, after that, your principal, he calls me several times. He said, I have sent WhatsApp message to him. My WhatsApp was not working. Then, because I changed my phone, I promise that I will come here at 9:30 sharp. Today not much traffic, I could make it. I would love to come here once again. I would like to deliver a talk exclusively on lead poisoning. Number one, environmental hazard, 100% preventable. Okay? They said I got unleaded petrol to this country, not me. My team got it. I was part of the team. I cannot claim any, thing for myself. I am here today, I may go somewhere. None of us as individuals are permanent. Remember, we have come through four stages, four activities. What is the first activity in your life, in my life? As a child, play, 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 play. We all played, isn't it? That is the first activity. We had a control. Before that, there was an activity called birth. We had no control. Birth and death, we have no control. We have absolute control on play, 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 play. Good game, bad game. Second activity, after you started growing, your parents pushed you into some school, whether you liked it or not. College. Learn, 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 learn. Again, you have a control to learn good thing or a bad thing. You have a control. Your teachers have control. Parents have control. After learn, 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 your principal showed how many industries are there to take you, to give you job. Work, work. Earn, 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 earn. Play, 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 play. Learn, learn, learn. Now earn, earn, earn. That day is there. Wait, you will get a lot of money. There also you can have control. You must have control. Otherwise you can earn by illegal ways. If doctor makes a mistake, one patient dies. If engineer makes a mistake, hundreds of people will die. You have to control. Earning. At my age, 75, I cannot play. Nobody will allow me to join you also. I cannot learn. They will not give me seat to learn. Nobody will give me job also. No earn. What is left? Return, return, return. Whatever I have learned and earned, return back to the society. For that, develop that attitude now itself. Remember, we cannot carry our memories with us. You cannot carry your memory with you. we have to return back to the society. With this, once again, I do not want to thank anybody here. If we are like-minded people, there are no thanks, no excuses between us.